Often I'm left with about 5 to 6 rotis, and I keep thinking what I should do out of them. Here's one simple recipe that I kind of do once in a while. Tear about 5 to 6 rotis and pulse them using a mixer into coarse powder. There's no hard and fast rule that you should be using leftover rotis. You can do this upma using fresh rotis as well. You'll need a couple of other ingredients that you use for regular upma: the curry leaves or the kadi patta, coriander leaves, a medium-sized onion, medium-sized tomato, half a lemon. For the tadka, mustard seeds, jeera, urad dal, all about half teaspoon each. And I'll be chopping the onions and tomatoes fine, also the coriander leaves, and I'll be separating the leaves from the curry leaf strands. Here's how I chop the onions and the tomatoes. You'll also need about 2 green chilies, which I forgot to mention. Slit them lengthwise. So you have all your veggies ready, and now we are ready for the tadka. You'll also need a little turmeric and groundnuts. Take about a tablespoon of oil and heat it in a heavy bottom pan or kadai, and then add in the mustard seeds and then a single green chili slit lengthwise. You can increase the spice level by adding more. And next goes the curry leaves, and give a quick stir. You'll also add in the jeera and urad dal next. Oh, here goes this prestige logo of my stove. Once you add in the urad dal and jeera, fry until the dal turns golden yellow in color, and then you add in groundnuts and a little turmeric to it. Fry until the groundnuts are fried completely. Next, add in the onions and tomatoes that has been chopped, and saute until they are cooked well. Add in the required salt. Here, for the mixture, I added about 3/4 teaspoon of salt. Make sure your chapatis had less salt in it. And then add in the mixture that we pulsed in the mixie or the grinder. Add the chopped coriander leaves for garnish and increase or enhancing the taste. Squeeze half a lime. Mix well.